First of all, for last 4 days, you know, in our club, it's happened quite two big events. You know, first one in transfer of Mudrik to Chelsea, England, and the second one, the president of our club, Rinat Akhmetov, donating $25 million to defenders of Mariupol, and this money will go to provide treatments defenders and their families in different kinds. You know, like. And even psychological treatment. And president will create, you know, a top professional team who will be involved in this process. And every dollar spent, it will be publicly, stated, and everybody will know what's going on with this fund and how all money is spent properly.
You've spoken of your sadness that Mudrik had to leave for a Western club. Do you worry that other Ukrainian talent will follow him?
You know, it's life, because we understood when we are doing this kind of transfers, everybody look at this and everybody want to move. I mean, to move to big top leagues, you know, to play for big clubs. And it's normal question. Maybe even it's good because it's motivating our players to be better, to train better, to play better and to look better, you know.
Well, indeed. I mean, you had a big exodus of international talent when Russia attacked Ukraine, but could one argue that that's given local Ukrainian talent the chance to shine?
You know, when war started and our team didn't play almost, our club didn't play almost half a year, you know, and after that we started our championship and maybe, you know, FIFA released all our foreign players, we lost coaching staff. And when our league decided to start to play football, you know, we invited all our Ukrainian boys what we had. Even we have taken some of them from loans and some of them even we bought from European clubs. And we start. And, you know, we showed a very good game. You know, I mean, when we participated in the Champions League group stage, we got third position. And I'm telling you that I am proud how our boys play, you know, what kind of football they've shown. And I stay in club almost 20 years, you know, and football, I mean, kind of football what our boys shown, it's one of the best period in my life in the club, you know, and they played attractive, very good football. And for me, I am very, very proud for our boys, for our coaching staff.
You've spoken of your dream that Mudrik will return to play with Chelsea in the Donbass Arena. Have Chelsea actually promised you a fixture?
You know, first of all, when we had the final meeting on Saturday with Chelsea representative, it was Baghdad and sport director of Chelsea. We talked a lot, and first of all, we put in our contract, and it was, let's say, common decision to play one friendly match in London in August. When I organized conversation of my president, Rinat Akhmetov, and Baghdad, co-owner of Chelsea. They talked, it was very, very good conversation, and my president invited him, you know, to play our friendly game in Donetsk, in Donbass Arena, when war will be finished.
Do you think that clubs like yours have been given sufficient support from the international football authorities, the likes of UEFA and FIFA?
You know, if we are talking about support from our international football, let's say, we can divide it in some areas. Because, for example, we called to European clubs to help us with generators. Because, you know, that Russians destroy completely almost our critical infrastructure, you know. And for our population, for our refugees, it's very important to have enough generators, you know, especially in winter time. And European clubs donated to us 100 generators, and these clubs, it's like Benfica, Real Madrid, Inter Milan, another one, you know, it was a big pleasure from their side. And also they provide some kind of donations, you know, just directly, for example, Benfica provide five tracks of donations for refugees, and et cetera, et cetera. If we are talking about, for example, bodies like European Club Association, they generated 1 million euro and sent also to Ukrainian clubs to help. And but, for example, if we are talking about FIFA, you know that we have quite big claims against them because after war started, they didn't help Ukrainian clubs, they just destroyed them because they issued Annex 7, you know, According to this annex, they just released all foreign players, and we lost, you know, our investments, and we had no chance to negotiate with players to put them on a loan, for example, or sell them. They just let them go free, and that's it. And you know that we sue them in CAS, and CAS, you know, declined our claim. And after this, I mean, this, what they did, you know, we go to Federal Court of Swiss, and we'll go to European Commission because, you know, they've broken completely anti-monopoly regulation. And the most important, FIFA created such kind of system that in CAS, that it's not possible to win against FIFA, you know. I mean, FIFA can do whatever they want, but system cannot allow to win, you know. And we want to change the system. We want to broken because everybody should be in the same level with law, you know. Nobody can be above law. Therefore, I mean, next couple of days, we will issue our statement about the situation, and I believe that it will come to you also, and you will understand deeply what's going on there.